So I'm Mario Campolargo. I'm the director for Net Futures in DG Connect. I'm an engineer by training, but I think that throughout my professional life, I'm a particular observer of how Europe can be built and how can we bring research and innovation to create a brighter future for Europe. So in the times where we are in overcoming a difficult crisis, you ask me what are the main challenges for the ICT industry in Europe. Well, I see two aspects to that one. First, we need to reinforce the sectors where we are traditionally strong, and we have a lot of assets in Europe that come from the traditional ability to provide communication networks, good software, good and innovative software, up to bringing other areas where we are not so predominant in the past, and that represents new areas in the market that are important for Europe to develop. This has to do a lot with innovation. If you see when we launch now the new Horizon 2020, we link research and innovation in a more clear way. This means that we need to shorten the time to market. We need to work together with the actors in Europe to make that research leads into innovation and into products in the market. And that's precisely where the Future Internet PPP plays an important role. It's a kind of a laboratory where we can experiment how we can balance and get the right balance between demand and supply. Yes, we have a strong technological supply side, i.e. we have been putting together through the FIWARE platforms, you know, generic enablers that are technologically advanced, that represent the state of the art, and that allow us to do a lot of things. But at the same time, we started also identifying what are the demanded side, the requirements from the market. We promoted test cases, we worked with people from so many other industries that need the internet of the future to cope with their requirements. And by blending the supply and demand side, we created this laboratory. We create an ecosystem in which we can develop new applications based on standardized generic enablers, as much as we can in open source, available to everybody. I mean, the fact that we have put in place this Future Internet Lab, the FILAB, is just a way of making sure that a lot of SMEs, a lot of our entrepreneurs can just go there, recognize that they exist, use them, make applications on them, and with this promote innovation. And there you see, at the same time, we are pushing very far what the current actors, traditional actors in the internet domain can provide, but we are challenging the innovation side through the web entrepreneurs and the small and medium enterprise that are so innovative. I think that this is a precursor of what we need to do more in Horizon 2020, and the lessons learned from this exercise are very fundamental for us. So what is the concept? What do we mean when we put those two words together, future and internet? Let's start with the word internet. Internet is an economy drive. You know, today we talk about the internet-based economy, so much more than technology, much more than, you know, a number of areas of research that we can associate, you know, to internet. Internet is an economic drive for our society. So yes, because it is an economic drive, we need to maintain the pace of innovation and drive coming from the internet, and we need to continuously research on internet. And researching on internet is research on software, on networks, on computing, on cloud, on aspects that are more related to the legal framework where those things exist, be it privacy or certification or, you know, aspects of standardization. But then why do we put the word future before internet? Because, indeed, if we want to preserve this role of internet in the future, we need to anticipate it. So we need to promote research that will allow us to figure out what the internet of today can produce in the future as innovations. So we need to be anticipatory. We need to promote research in a new generation of networks. You know that we are investing very much in the 5G initiative. This will anticipate a full integrated ubiquitous network with capabilities that are unforeseen at this moment in time. And this has not only to do with the mobile aspect, not only to do with the new protocols or radio access or new spectrum sharing facilities or technologies. It has to do also with the integration of flexible integration of fixed and mobile. And we have also to see what are the new business models, what are the innovation paths that we need to exploit to make sure that we develop future-proof ecosystems of innovation in Europe. So, internet in one side, a driver of the economy in Europe, the future because we are anticipating it, and we are trying to put ourselves in the year 2020 and see if we today prepare the technology, the research and the innovation that will allow us to grab the future, the fruits of this investment in a few years from now. This will be our aim, is that our economy in the years to come will benefit from the technologies that we research and that we innovate at this stage. So we are today in a moment where our investments of the past have created this platform for innovation that is adjacent to the notion of future internet and that is called by us as FIWARE, just because the project that has developed the foundation, the technology foundations for that, is the FIWARE project. What are the merits of this platform? First, is a platform that will offer to a large plethora of young entrepreneurs, of SMEs, or of professional developers, the opportunity to develop new applications. We have generic enablers that are standard pieces of software, well tested, with recognized interfaces. Some of them even developed in open software that can be used and reused again to provide new applications that are useful in a plethora of application fields. I'm very impressed when I see youngsters, and I just met 10 minutes ago a youngster that is no more than 15, 16 years that has been using the FIWARE platform to develop applications. This is very encouraging because in one sense makes the FIWARE elastic enough to cope with the requirements of a young entrepreneur and that a professional that is developing applications for a smart city or for logistics. But it's also very encouraging because we create opportunities for the developers to be independent from the providers and to have a standardized platform that can be the basis for innovation in so many fields. I'm particularly keen in envisaging in my own mind that smart cities can use FIWARE platform to develop the applications of the future. It's very important that we develop human-centered smart cities, and therefore there is so many requirements that are coming from the fact that we live together in a city, that the opportunities to develop applications that make our life more easy, more efficient, but also more enjoyable are endless. And FIWARE provides the generic enablers for Internet of Things, for clouds, for contents, for with the security requirements, etc., that will allow us to develop the applications of the future. So FIWARE for us is this basis on which we build ecosystems of innovation. It's an opportunity to bring web entrepreneurs and young researchers together with us in a movement that I would like to see spreading all over Europe and beyond. FILAB is available to the innovators that are in Lithuania, in Portugal, in Spain, but also the ones that are in Brazil or Mexico or in Korea. They can use it and they can make sense of that. So if I would turn now and if I would have in front of me young entrepreneurs, I would say, just use this. This is an opportunity. Criticize it. Tell us if it is simple to use, if you require other generic enablers, if some are not adequate, but use it. Because if you use it, you make a bright future for you and for Europe.